In Minecraft, there are two types of lag, client-side lag and server-side lag. In this video, we will be showing you how to best optimize your server-side in-game performance to get the most out of your server. First, make sure you have the appropriate resources. If you have a 3 GB plan but have several people constantly online and several plugins, you can check your console to see how this impacts your server. You may need to upgrade your plan if necessary. Ensure your server is not maxing out its resources. That's why I host with Gravel, as they offer the most affordable plans starting at less than $1 per GB. Next, we recommend running a version like Paper, which is better optimized for large numbers of players and plugins. Even if you plan on running a vanilla server, I highly recommend this version. Now, go to your server properties folder. In this folder, we will be making some adjustments. Lower the simulation distance to 5 or smaller, which is the processing distance. Set the view distance to 7 or 8. Having this high with many players will cause the server to render more chunks than needed. Save and exit the file. Now go to the config file and then to the paper world defaults. Go to line 70 and set it to true. On line 69, if you have a lot of players on your server, keep this the same. However, if you have a smaller player base, you can lower this to 10 or 13. Edit the entity per chunk limit using your preferences or the GitHub linked below. Edit the despawn ranges to be 56 and 30 for each, then save. Lastly, we will be adjusting settings in the bucket.yml file and spigot.yml file. In bucket.yml, adjust the tick rates per section to 400, except for the bottom one and the monster spawns. In spigot.yml, go to line 101 where we have the entity activation range. I will be copying this from the GitHub guide, but feel free to adjust these to your liking. Set the villager inactive tick to false if you have a villager farm. We have now covered some of the most significant things you can do to optimize your server. If you wish to further optimize, read through the GitHub article. If you want a part 2, make sure to comment on this video and subscribe for more.